On YouTube, alright, Shay's car, her Cadillac Verter got clogged. I told you guys this. Doesn't it suck? What's it do? Bogs and backfires and all kinds of cool shit. We got Brad out here helping us, which is awesome. Learning him how to take bolts out. Here, dude, I don't even think I have an 8. Fuck. Can you get your tools out of the trunk, please? So she bought herself a brand new Magnaflow high flow cat. Instead of me trying to break these stupid bolts off of here, as you can see how rusty they are never coming off there. So instead of me trying to fight that out, I have me a spare. I'm hoping this is not the PT Cruiser. I'm pretty sure it's a single can neon. Either way, I know I have a spare single can neon manifold. We're gonna take it off of the head and as I was saying, I'm gonna take it off of the head right here, and then instead of me trying to fight those bolts off, I'll take this one off and I'll bolt it to here with brand new bolts and then put this underneath the car together like that, because this manifold's not cracked or anything, so we know that's good. So right now we're trying to get these bolts out. These 3 8 millimeters. See these, Brad? Those are the three we're trying to get out of that one. Dude, you just took out the one that was right here. So we need an 8 millimeter. And that long ass extension. I love that little tool set. See if I can get them myself. They're probably just gonna break off, which is normal. I've never got a manifold apart. This one's just spinning. Spinning, so let's try the other two. I already knew it was gonna be a pain in my car. Oh, yep, that was fun. Oh no, that was not coming off either. What is fucking new? That's why the ones on that manifold are stuck on there. I think we might get one off. Here, you want to hold this right here? Let's see if we can get this bolt off without bringing it. Oh yeah, we got one out. What a fucking Christmas miracle. This lady swears to God that Frank sells smoke detectors. She's like, He makes them and he sells them and he installs them for free. Cause she asked me if I had to install one for her. She bought it and I said for $20. And she's like, well, Frank? I'm like, yeah, my father-in-law. She's like, oh, it's your father-in-law? You have a wife? I'm like, yeah. She's like, oh. And like, it was just so bizarre how she's crazy. And she's like, well, Frank says he makes them and he installed for free. Like, oh, I never heard of Frank doing anything for free. He won't even get Andrea's jobs for free. He charged Andrea's $50 for a job. Ain't that fucked up? Yeah. Oh, dude. That's not coming up. So we're gonna have to break this thing off here somehow. I'm gonna bend it up like this. Maybe we'll just get the bolts from behind it somehow. I'll probably have to break it. I need a pry bar.
You gonna break something on my car?
Yeah, that costs you.
Do I need that?
Huh? Nah. Just
break. Want my car to fire?
Nah.
I think you wanted to.
Dirty hot.
Huh?
Dirty hot. What? Stone. Apparently to the cops. You look at your car the most. He said he was looking at your car the most. Apparently you have a bunch of hot cars. I thought he was talking about something fast or something. Alright, so we bent that out of the way. Now we can reach these bolts instead of fucking trying to fuck with that. We'll get that once we get it out. Same with the O2 sensor. We'll get that bitch out once we get it out of there. We'll cut it off underneath the car. I'm going to try to get these bolts lubed up with some. I already put some PB Blast on there, but I'm going to put some more PB on there and some more WD. Mixing up the medicine. Lubricant, but people use it as one. So we gotta clean this shit like crazy before we put it back together, because this shit will catch fire. You getting a shot? Soak everything. We got that PB, now we put some WD on there. Because you know, this shit has like no pressure in it at all. It just leaks out like pisses. I know I have a better camera than that.
I got four way.
This is the good shit. Lubricant demolish. No, not really. It's demoistant. Penetrate. I demoisted you. This was weird. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Hopefully I'm getting that last bolt somewhat. Hopefully that bitch breaks right off and we'll let it sit for a couple minutes. Break it off, jack the car up. We'll cut the cat off tomorrow because it's like, what, fucking 2 o'clock? 11:35. I can still cut it off tonight. But look how perfect this one is. I wish this was the one we cut off the car. If you line the flange up and you come back here, it's fucking perfect, dude. I don't know how I cut it off that perfect. That's crazy. Hers I cut off here, so I'm going to cut it off some more so it's even. Oh, because I took it out. That was the first one I ever got out. I slid it out of the factory fucking spot. You can't do that very often. That's why it's so flush. Direct fit, dumbass. Factory direct fit. Makes sense, don't it? I'm sometimes a goof. I'm always a goof. See, I just, the only thing I feel like is different is because of this piece, but it's the same length, so it's got to fit. Alright, so I'll be back in just a few minutes, or a second. As another day, you just missed Shay do her squats, sorry. She jacked the car up for me. As we said last night, we got the manifold disconnected, we got all the bolts out of the manifold. Brad helped us do that. Now we're going to climb underneath. I'm just going to try to disconnect this cat. I need my rag on my mat. Coolest mat in the world. No 240 video today. Sorry, guys. It's going to told you it's going to be the slowest build you ever seen. It's going to take a long time. I'll show you guys something really safe. Look at this. Sick. You see that? One wheeling. Alright, so there was my chopped up weld job from where I tried to beat the cat out. It actually turned out pretty nice, if I don't say so myself. So we're going to try to unbolt it to air. We know it's not going to work very well, but we're going to try. And then we're going to try to slot that pipe out. But there's a mount. Yeah, there's a mount in there somewhere. I'm pretty sure it's in the way. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. I don't know. Guess I'm gonna climb up under the front and look up in. So, yeah. I just know the mount for the manifold, because they brace it so it doesn't crack, is under here. I know it's hard to get to. Where's it at? See, and they got all these exhaust shields and shit in the way. I'm pretty sure it's underneath of this heat shield. So we'll take this bolt off, that bolt off, and that bolt. So we got 8, a 15, and a 15. And hopefully that heat shield will go out of the way, and then we can see where that mount is that holds the manifold on.
Me too.
When did we put an oil pan gasket on here? I don't remember it all now. There's a massive oil leak in here somewhere. I'm surprised you don't leak all over the driveway.
Leak all over what?
Low life.
Are you sure it's not all that shit you sprayed on there last night?
I'm positive.
Huh?
I'm positive. Alright guys, well, we'll remove these bolts. Actually, that looks like a 17, and that's definitely a 15, that's definitely an 8 or a 10. We're gonna move this out of the way, and then hopefully we can find this bracket that I know was in here. So, well, I'll see you guys in just a minute. So, I was wrong about this bolt. It was an 18, that one was a 15. This one won't come out. That one's fucking came out perfectly fine. It was a 10. I'm going to try a half inch wrench on this one and try to get it out. It's one of the bottom exhaust flange bolts. We're going to try it. After we try it, we'll be back. If not, we'll put some heat on it and then we'll get it off with a pair of ice screws. So, see you in a minute. Hey guys, so we got that bolt out right there. We got this one out right there. We got that 10 millimeter from there. And we broke this 13 or 12 off of here. So now we're ready to take that bolt off back there. Holding it on right there. And that one's gonna be a pain in the ass. I'll probably just put heat on it anyway so I can get it off here without breaking it. And yeah, stove pipe. Hey guys, so we couldn't get it out of the slot, so I cut it. And then I pulled it out of there. And then now I got the cat coming down. We're gonna try to take it out the bottom. Slid this piece out of here so the new one will slide in. We got this big ass cat coming out. I forget what the big cats are. We're gonna call it a bobcat. Trying to send it down through the bottom. It'll probably have to come up through the cutter. So I'm gonna try to finger this thing, and as soon as I figure out how to do it, I'll let you guys know. So I'll see you in a minute. Alright guys, we got Shay taking our valve cover off to get it out of the way so we don't break the crankcase vent right there. Plastic junk. That's this tough woman. Snap. I'll work on my own car. We're gonna pull the header and cat out this way because we can't get it down through the bottom. And I don't feel like just separating it. So the valve cover will give us a little bit more clearance and we won't break anything in the process. I'll be able to look underneath the valve cover too, just for the hell of it. Let me see. Yeah, you got it. It gets stuck on the spark plug tubes. I guess get away, it's wherever, yeah, that's fine. If you don't want to sit there anymore. Head looks nice and clean now. Real
except
clean
for
head.
This shit.
What?
Fuck's that thing?
Part of the spark plug too. Holy shit. Baked one there, ain't it? Whatever.
Fucking dick. I told you something's wrong with that.
Told you. You need a rag?
Unless you want grease or oil or whatever on your phone.
Oh, yeah. The DSLR. Isn't it? What are we doing?
Nah.
Nothing. What's he doing?
Get over here, lay down on your bed, and go to sleep. Get on your bed. On your bed. Huh. You're a dick, dude.
Get on your bed.
Fucking asshole.
Still not enough. The stupid exhaustion, man.
Squeeze it down.
I'm trying, I'm not strong enough.
Well, how are your He-Man? You bent it off there, didn't you?
There's a pry bar. Don't forget to plug, unplug your few something, guys. Flipper should go down because, you know, that's what they do. They go up and they go down. It'll be easier to put it back in because I'll be able to put the heat shield on after I have it in there. If I put it on there. Now the only thing that's gonna mess me up now is that.
Once you get past this big hump, it should be fine on that. I would think. See what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm. Not so bad.
Working at a body shop, I look at things, I observe everything. If I don't think it'll fit or it's not going the right way, I say something.
And there you go, guys, that's how you get a fucking Cadillac and rotor off the goddamn neon.
Keep the shit calm down, motherfucker.
Look at this. Yeah, it's the old exhaust. It looks the same as the Mopar one. Ain't that crazy? Because they're the same job. We need to port this bitch. You got a new oil pressure sensor on it. Brand new. All right,
dope pie.
Ooh, look at that one. Need to get those out of there. Put your O2 sensors. This one's already got one, so we don't need to.
Well, you just broke mine.
Need this one out again. I didn't break it. Fine. Need to take this one out, put it in here. Oh, that one's in the cat. This one's out of the cat. Might run better.
I don't know. Well, hopefully it runs better. And it passes stupid fucking emissions. I hate that shit, man.
Time to put this one in there. We actually want to clean this up before we stick it in there, make our life a little easier. So we're going to take a little razor blade to that. We're going to scrape off all this old gasket. And after we clean that up, we'll be back and we'll show you what it looks like. Guys, we got the cat bolted on there with a new gasket in there. Shay is the only person around with an upside down boat, you know, that's pretty pimp. Got this nice lock nut on here with these three washers, factory boat with a washer, and a factory boat without a washer. It's nice and tight, shouldn't leak. Now we're gonna jam it down the crotch of this thing. And, after we put it in there, we're gonna go for a test drive, and this thing ought to run real nice. Get me going in there. Going in deep. Oh yeah, put the penis in the hole. Penis in the vagina. Why'd it go in so much easier?
Because you didn't have the fucking heat shield on the top, but it's not as big as that one.
You need to hold this right here.
I only have two hands.
We're going to put the camera down for a little bit. I got to push this cat in this hole while she pulls the exhaust up and I got it in, and we can't have all that dirt in there, so we'll be back in just a few. I gotta drag the car up, so Brad's probably gonna have to do this, so you might have to record, so we might see something. All right guys, I'm gonna climb over here and I'm gonna guide it in. Brad's up there holding it like the penis. All right lay it down, son. Put it in the vagina. It doesn't look like it's going to. Okay, technical difficulties happening now. It looks like I'm going to have to put this pipe inside of that pipe. Which is okay, but first I gotta get this gasket thing off here. Why is it like that? It's supposed to go inside. That's what direct fit would be, right? Inside.
The way it was, the original one was on there.
What I'm getting here is this gotta go inside. That's the only way it's gonna fit. Alright, pull that up a little bit. Never mind. Now you can lay it down. Yeah. That's fine.
Huh?
That should be good. I'm gonna have to bend this thing back and get this stupid clamp off here. I wonder why it won't fit.
I got off in my bedroom.
Got that clamp off there. Now we're gonna bend this back with a pair of channel locks. I'm gonna go get the channel locks. I'm gonna bend that back. We'll be back for take two. Alright, guys, we're going for take two. I bent it shut. Back it up there. Alright, down. Hold up. Alright guys, I'm gonna have to bend this thing up. You can't really see it. I'll be back after my battery's charged. Alright guys, so we got the manifold on there, pulled bolted down, shine light over here because my battery's down on my phone. You can see we got the old bolts bolted down. We didn't get bolted underneath. We got to buy an adapter because the new Cadillac converter is the same size pipe as the factory. I thought it was going to go inside, but it didn't. We got the valve cover back on. We got the coil pack on. Everything else is plugged up. Now we're taking this O2 sensor off. I usually use a big adjustable wrench, smack it once or twice. Sometimes you gotta use heat. This one came out pretty easy. The manifold I used had an O2 sensor in the top stream. We just need the bottom stream. We're gonna stick this bottom stream in there. It's underneath the car, which is a pain in the booty. I need that adjustable wrench too. As I lied, no pipe adapter needed. I just squeezed the pipe a little bit. It was a little bit where I spread it apart to get it apart. You just remove that clamp like I showed you. Get it to where it's round. It'll slide inside the new cat. And we'll put a clamp on there, but I just weld it. And after, I'm going to put two tacks on it tonight, and then we'll weld it tomorrow, but I want to take it for a test drive right now, so... let's tack this thing on here, and I'll see you guys in a minute. Guys, we're out here getting Shay's cat welded on. Got my dad's big snap-on welder.
Anybody got a pair of pliers?
In the trunk, yeah. Alright, I got a pair.
Getting gay, little pliers.
I'm laughing. We got four blocks. We're super status monster trucking.
Turn it on for a second, dude.
Yeah, power.
Pretty funny. You want your hat mask?
Alright, I'll tell you this once, man. Get up on the argon tank and dial that down when I'm using it to 10. Much better. Damn, Joe, that fucking did good.
Much better?
Oh, yeah. Too hot.
Looks good to me. Start it up. Yeah.
Now hook the battery back up.
Wow. Shay hooked the battery back up. Now it's time for his first start without the exhaust leak.
Rednecky there, girl.
Much better. Here, shut it, let me feel it. Huh?